come get some!
Well, Dusty, if you saw the green pay-per-view last night, is preparing for tonight the same way he prepared for last night, and that's with a bevy of burritos.
I am not hungry. Thanks. Oh, good night. What did Dustin say? 33 burritos in that tray? Is that what he said?
33 burritos. You're right.
Good night. Dusty's going to walk those things down before Ric Flair has to make the big kiss later on. But you'll see the empty waste of Rick Steiner as a result of what went down last night at WCW Green. Booker T, what a triumphant return. Rick Steiner, as brutal as ever. But at the end of the night, Booker T did come away with the U.S. trap. And Rick Steiner, Tony, quite honestly, he dominated that matchup. Booker T won it at the end. Steiner's furious. He may take it out on the K-Dog Conan.
Conan and Rick Steiner is our next bout here. Fans everywhere, next Monday is a night that you will never forget. It's Monday, the 26th of March, 1 week, Panama City Beach, Boardwalk Beach Resort. 29 years of World Championship Wrestling here on the Turner Networks. And it all comes down to our season finale, and we will be honored to bring you next week's telecast, all titles on the line, title versus title, the two biggest, Steiner and Booker T. The invite for all former champions to show up, bring their boots, strap them up, and get involved. Who knows what's going to happen tonight that we will never forget is happening in only a week.
Who knows who's going to be there? Bischoff opened the door wide open, and speaking of wide open, Conan left himself wide open for that attack from the DFG.
Think many ways, and of course, we'll talk about it next week. Next week's telecast will be a fitting end and a great beginning for our promotion. Up! Down goes Conan from the Steiner line. Wiped him out. Steiner, that wide vertical base, yanking on the nose. He is so ruthless.
Last night, Conan and Hugh Morris down to the feet. Conan wants a little retribution, wants another shot, but all he's going to get is a rear chin lock from the dog-faced gremlin.
Pounding on top of the head. Look at this. Screaming at the referee to shut up as he just wastes Conan. So many ways that he can take his left punches. These are just forearm blasts from the top. And nowhere that Conan can go because he's straddling Conan to boot.
A couple of things about Rick Steiner. First, what's up with the Magnificent Seven? He appears to be the focus of the entire investigation conducted by Bagwell, Luger, and Animal. And also, the return of Shane Douglas. Last night at the Green pay-per-view, the man suffering two broken wrists at the hands of the dog-faced gremlin cost him the U.S. title.
You know, earlier tonight, the accusations were flying towards the total package, and then when the total package was face down, it changed. You can't argue with Buff Bagwell and Animal and Ric Flair and Luger because the dog-faced gremlin, the only man who hasn't been attacked yet in the back.
I don't know if Rick Steiner knows he's a suspect in this deal yet.
One, two.
Oh.
That drama unfolds with the camcorder in the back. Rick Steiner tries to unfold Conan in the ring. And Conan, you can just see the pain and now the determination and the meanness that is Rick Steiner. Conan will be sent near side with an Irish whip. He missed the Steiner line, rolling thunder up and down. He whacked him with that, did Conan, and he goes for the gut. Face jam to the mat.
What a nice recovery by the K-Dog. Rick Steiner finally went down for the rolling thunder clothesline. Conan back up, but Steiner missed him. Got him on the top of the head. I thought Conan had ducked it.
And then punctuates it with an elbow. Back to his feet, but staggering is Conan. Conan sent near side again. Everything is with such authority and such impact from Rick Steiner. Only a two. Conan is still in it.
I don't know if that's a good idea or not.
Not with this attack he's getting from Rick Steiner. Wondering how much of this anger that's just emanating from the dog-faced gremlin has to do with what happened to his brother earlier tonight. Just pigeonholed into a title defense against Booker T next Monday night on the season finale at Nitro.
Title versus title, it's what it will be. And how many people can say that they have gone in the ring and have dominated Conan like this throughout Conan's great career? Not many, I can tell you that. Conan has no defense at all. The only defense right now for Conan is put his hand up over his head and try to stop the onslaught.
He's going to try to break his arm. Conan's out. Steiner could break it if he wanted, I think. Conan at the ropes, but has been knocked in the next week. Doesn't know where he is.
You're right, Scott. He can reach out there maybe and cause the break. And Steiner just cranking here on the arm. For Steiner, the upper body, the chest, the arms are so dominant. He's so strong. But the fact is that Steiner seemingly cannot be hurt as well. He is tough on both ends. Conan back up. Conan will send Steiner in.
Again with that power back body drop.
Every time you think Conan has it turned around in a great cover.
Shane Douglas.
Shane Douglas out of nowhere, much like last night, and he clubs him on the back of the head with that cast, and he's out.
What a shot with that cast in the back of the head of Steiner.
Conan makes a cover, but this match has been thrown out. The involvement of Shane Douglas and referee Billy Silverman has disqualified now Conan, so Steiner's going to win this thing. Oh, no. Oh, rabbit punch in the back of the head. What if this man is a maniac?
He's trying to...
Speaking of maniacs, here comes Hugh Morris.
And the laughing man isn't laughing now. He's on cork and on the DMG.
The tag team partner of Conan has come in. And Conan, he had seen enough. And that cheap shot from behind when the match was over. Out goes the DFG, but the damage has been done to Conan. Speaking of damage, how about the damage from Shane Douglas?
Wow, one shot with that cast. Knocked Steiner out.
We're coming back with more.